All right, so I got the invite today. I've actually just played along with it for maybe half an hour or so. So I installed the extension in Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to show you some very, very small first impression examples on how this works. So I created a new file here. It's just an untitled file. I haven't even saved it, to be honest, but it will work anyways. And it's JavaScript because I work mostly in JavaScript and TypeScript. So that's what I choose for this one. I can actually remove this sidebar. Maybe bump it up a little bit more. And I'm going to show you how this works. And it seems that GitHub Copilot uses the naming of your functions a lot to interpret what you want to do. So if I create a function, add two numbers, you can see that it instantly gives me the correct solution. And if you press Control and Enter, I'm on a Mac, you can see that it gives you different solutions here. It takes a little bit of time here for it to calculate it. You can see here, actually, it didn't even calculate it. So it's some bug here. Add two numbers. Yeah, we're going to use that one. So you can see that there's still bugs and stuff. It won't work flawlessly. And I noticed that also. I tried it out very, very quickly with React and TypeScript. And it almost worked. The one annoying thing is that it hadn't adapted to my own code style. For example, I use functional components all the time. I don't use class components. So most of the suggestions I get is with class components. It wasn't really useful for me, to be honest. But I guess it will be in the future because it will evolve. It will learn more for each day that goes by. So at least now it can't replace my role and my job as a developer. All right, so let's move on here and try another example. Let's say that we want to check if a word is a palindrome. So function is palindrome. And we have the word. And you can see that it instantly gives me the correct solution. But I don't know why it won't bring up the solutions here. That's strange, really. Function is palindrome. Word. It should give me the solutions there, but it doesn't seem to give me that. So I'm actually going to disable it, reload. And I'm going to enable it again. I think it's good to show this also because it isn't a flawless experience. There are still some bugs in it. So let's see how this works now. Yeah, and now it works. So you can see it gives me a lot of solutions here on how to check if a word is a palindrome. But I think I prefer this one-liner. So that's pretty cool. And I used Control and Enter on this one. I'm on a Mac. Okay, let's try something else. Function. We're going to do a Fibonacci number. Fibonacci, yeah, I think that actually is correct. Let's see if they have a one-liner here. No. If I type in something else here, Fibonacci numbers, and there should be a one-liner. I actually had it before, but now it won't even show it to me. So, okay, yeah, you can see there's some bugs in this still. So yeah, let's use a solution there for now. But there should be a one-liner there. But let's say that you want to do something more advanced. And one thing I noticed that's great is that, for example, if you want to grab something from an API, it already knows the endpoint URL for the API, for example. I wanted to try out to grab a character from the Star Wars API. So what I did is that I created a function, fetch character from Swappy API. And I have the character ID, and let's see what it gives us. So it actually grabs the correct URL here, and it will grab it with the character ID, and this one will work. So that's actually pretty neat because you don't need to do a lot of Googling to find the correct endpoint and stuff. So it's almost like having, for example, Stack Overflow built in to your code editor, and that's pretty cool. So I'm going to do one little more small example here. GitHub Copilot can also interpret what you want to do regarding your comments you put in your code. So for example, add Weben to each element in the array. OK, okay, so I want to loop through an array and I want to add Vaben to each element. So I create a function, add Vaben, and we have the array. And let's see what it gives us. So there you have it. It returns an array that it will map through and add Vaben. And that's pretty cool. That's a one-liner. So that's probably the shortest one you can do. It actually works pretty great, but it's not still there. I think it won't replace your job or anything like that, but it can be helpful in some situations, I think. I will try it out more, of course, and see how it evolves and how it gets smarter and smarter with this AI that's built in. But for now, this is enough. I just wanted to show you some quick, small example on how GitHub Copilot works. So that's it for this video. See you in another one.